Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this last European Council press conference after the October summit. I first invite the President of the European Council, Donald Tusk, to take the floor.
Thank you, Preben. Good afternoon. Last night, the leaders discussed enlargement. The overwhelming majority wanted to open accession talks with North Macedonia and Albania. However, such a decision requires unanimity, and there was no unanimity yesterday. That is why the EU will revert to this issue before the Zagreb summit in May 2020. Let me be very clear. North Macedonia and Albania are not to blame for this. And the Commission reports are also clear that both these countries did what they were asked to do. And the adoption of the PRESPA agreement was a truly extraordinary achievement. So both countries have the right to start EU negotiations as of today. They are ready. Unfortunately, a few member states are not ready yet. This is why we didn't manage to reach a positive decision. Personally, I think it was a mistake, but I will not comment on it further. Today, I would like to send a message to our Macedonian and Albanian friends. Please do not give up. I fully understand your frustration because you did your share and we haven't. The EU is a complex political entity, and it is true that sometimes it takes too long to decide. But I have absolutely no doubt that one day you will become full members of the European Union. Today, leaders also discussed the priorities of the new Commission with President-elect von der Leyen, as well as the future EU budget. It was an important discussion that will continue in the following months. However, without Jean-Claude and myself around the European Council table, as you know. On this note, I want to thank Jean-Claude, my colleague and friend, for our friendship, for your loyalty and solidarity, and for our really great cooperation. And I also want to thank you, the media, for your tough but fair questions, for your patience, for staying up so late with us, and for laughing at some of our jokes. No, never funny, frankly speaking. Thank you. Thank you for everything.
Thank you. And now President Juncker of the European Commission.
Oui, cher Donald, mesdames et messieurs, chers amis, je suis très déçu du résultat qui a conclu notre débat sur l'élargissement. Il y a 5 années, en prenant la fonction qui est la mienne, j'ai dit au Parlement que pendant les 5 années à venir, pendant les 5 années de mon mandat, il n'y aurait pas d'autres élargissements. Cela avait provoqué beaucoup de déceptions dans la région des Balkans occidentaux, mais il s'est avéré, évidemment, ce qui était prévisible, qu'aucun État nouveau, aucun nouvel État serait à même de remplir les critères pour devenir membre. Mais ce à quoi nous avons assisté hier soir fut d'un tout autre ordre, parce qu'il ne s'agissait pas de dire si oui ou non la Macédoine du Nord et l'Albanie étaient prêtes pour rejoindre l'Union européenne. Il s'agissait de dire si oui ou non ils pourraient devenir, en étant candidats, des candidats avec lesquels nous aurions commencé les négociations. Le Conseil européen, dans sa majorité, aurait bien voulu le dire, mais il y avait certains États membres qui n'étaient pas encore prêts. C'est une lourde erreur historique, une lourde erreur historique. Et j'espère qu'elle aura été momentanée pour qu'elle ne s'inscrive pas dans la mémoire collective comme étant restée une erreur historique. Nous avons discuté aujourd'hui le cadre financier des 7 années à venir. très peu d'éléments nouveaux. J'ai rappelé au Conseil qu'ils avaient l'obligation, les membres du Conseil européen, de conclure rapidement ce débat. Si nous attendons la fin de l'année prochaine, nous perdrions deux autres années pendant lesquelles les chercheurs ne pourront pas chercher, les jeunes ne pourront pas participer au programme Erasmus, alors que c'est une des plus belles réussites de l'Union européenne. Le Conseil, j'en suis sûr, a du pain sur la planche pour arriver à se mettre d'accord sur le budget que la Commission a proposé. Parce que c'est une proposition sage qui combine les politiques qui furent et les nouvelles politiques qui doivent commencer. Ceci aura été le dernier Conseil européen de Donald et de moi-même. D'après les vérifications faites, c'était le 148e Conseil.
I think it was 118th Council I've been at. I don't think anybody else has been able to say that they've been to so many councils or European councils. I'd like to thank Donald for his friendship and working together so well with me. He evinced great leadership. We've been co-managing the ship a little bit. I'd like to thank you all, ladies and gentlemen. Some of you have been hanging around me for ages. Others have only come in most recently. I've learned a lot from you. I followed with a great deal of interest what you've written and what you've said on your programs. I think a lot of you have understood how important Europe is. I'm proud and will remain proud to have been a European. Thank you.
I now open the floor for your questions, and we start over here. Yes, Michael.
Thank you. Michael Peel, Financial Times. Chancellor Merkel has said that under the Brexit deal agreed that the UK will be a third country and therefore a rival. Is that also how you see it? And secondly, if I could ask you both a more personal question about how you see your legacies and how...